Hey team, so I'm going to get right into coaching today. Here's the lesson, mastering your mindset. Do we ever master it? Yeah. But I think that the mental brain training that we need to do every day is important as all the push-ups and the running and the burpees and all that good stuff. So today's lesson is really about a mental workout. And I'm gonna share with you one of the most game-changing exercises that you can do to absolutely own your endocrine function. In other words, what I promised, which is a hormone cascade raining down on you in euphoric proportions. Isn't that what we all want? To control our hormones to a point where we literally can trigger the onset of euphoria anytime. And guess what? That's what we're designed for. We're capable of that, and you can do it. So let's get into mindset training. I'm going to break it down. There are four steps to owning your mindset. And when you practice these, you will, as a result, manage your cortisol, which means you are going to experience less fatigue. You are going to have so much more focus. You are going to feel so much more confident, so much better about yourself, that you're going to enhance the performance of everything that you do, from being a mom to being a boss or an employee to being an athlete. Everything that you do is enhanced, and therefore you are balancing out the secretion of your feel-good hormones with your cortisol levels. And so everything that you eat and the way that you exercise is enhanced. Does that make sense? Okay, mindset training. There are four key steps. The first thing is to identify the thought that isn't working for you, right? And I talked about this when I coached you on mantras. So this is the next step. We're gonna dig deeper. So those thoughts that don't serve you, you have to be able to identify them first, right? You can't fix what you don't know is wrong. So, what are the thoughts that you think all day that just don't serve you? Identify them. Write them down. Look at what your mantras were. Step two, recognize that as the glitch that it is, because that's all it is. It is a brain glitch. Right? Here's our master operating system, and a negative thought is literally a glitch. And the glitch comes from maybe some childhood memory that is flashing back to you, or something somebody said to you when you were a kid that you fixated on, you implanted it in your brain, and it spit back out data that you still believe to be true, even though it has no basis in truth. Let me give you an example. Maybe when you were a kid, somebody said you were fat. Boom. And even though you know that that's not true, you've lived with that in your brain for 35 years. And so diets will never work for you because you have a brain glitch. You have a neural association with food, that the way you eat and how you eat, you're fat. You have perpetuated that. You have told yourself that your whole life. So when you think a thought that long, guess what? It becomes a belief. And that belief is then strengthened in your actions. So the actions you're taking make that belief more concrete. And it's a vicious cycle. So what you need to do is identify the thought, recognize it. It's a glitch. Here's the glitch. Now you can dig deeper. That's a whole other coaching lesson. We can dive really deep into how to break the glitch in terms of where it came from and everything. But even just the fact that you've identified it and see it as a glitch, now you want to change the focus. So pulling from your mantras from yesterday, you're going to take a mantra specific to this glitch and you're going to say it out loud. So if it was that you were trying to break that feeling of I'm fat, and your mantra is I'm strong and beautiful, then you need to empower yourself with that, change your focus immediately. As soon as that comes up, maybe you ate something, you started to feel guilty, and now you're going into that glitch and you stop. I am strong and I am beautiful. I am strong and I am beautiful. Okay, change the focus. Sometimes just changing the focus away from the negative thought, you're thinking it, and then just, I'll say to myself sometimes, oh my God, there it is. Oh my God, glitch. Oh my God, red alert. Like, just to get me out of that pattern, because that again will break that neural association and help you to form a new habit. And that's the fourth step. Put it all together. Okay, this is the mental workout, like doing your run every day or doing your strength training every day. You're going to do this mental training every day and you're going to have a cumulative effect. You're going to put those three things together in that fourth step of practice makes permanent. We've got to break that neural association. We've got to implant a new one. So identify the negative thought. See it for the glitch that it is. Change the focus, use a mantra, use a statement, snap yourself out of it, do something to get you out of the negative tape, and then put it all together by practicing it every single day. And that is how you master your mindset. When you function like that, you are essentially owning your cortisol, and you own your life. And that's what I want for you from the bottom of my heart. Peace out, much love.